Hey everyone, in today's video, we're talking about the impact that the coronavirus could have on your Social Security benefit and your other retirement income. Stay tuned. Hey, I'm Devin and this is my channel where I break down the complicated parts of retirement planning and help you use all the rules to your advantage. If you are new here, be sure to subscribe and hit that notifications bell, and that way, when we publish a new video like this one, you'll get notified and won't miss it. So you've probably noticed that the coronavirus has dominated the news. And now, with a bit of delayed reaction, the stock market has taken notice and has dropped a lot since February 24th. So how does this impact your Social Security benefit and your overall retirement income? It's because it's all tied to the health of the economy. If there's a hiccup, the impact is often far-reaching and surfaces in areas that you may not initially think it would. And in just a moment, I'm going to tell you exactly how this would impact not just your investment portfolio, but your Social Security benefits too. But to make it easier to understand, let's cover some background first. A widespread pandemic that wipes out a big section of the population is not what has the economy spooked. While the fatality rate is higher with this version of the coronavirus than it is with the seasonal flu, it's still not anywhere as close as it was with some of the other viral outbreaks we've had. For comparison, the seasonal flu has a fatality rate of less than 0.1%, which is one death per 1,000 cases. The coronavirus is substantially higher at a 2% rate, so 20 people for every 1,000 infected. But that's nowhere near the 9.6% rate from SARS, and certainly nowhere near the 34% from MERS. So why are we seeing all this upheaval? Well, primarily, the economy hates surprises. The big drop started after it was confirmed that the coronavirus had spread to Italy, South Korea, and Iran. This was completely unexpected, and it raised the alarm that the global impact could be greater than initially anticipated. Now, until this week, the consensus market view of the coronavirus had been pretty benign. But now that it's begun to spread to other countries, investors are clearly taking it more seriously because of the ripple effect this could end up having in the economy. Now, even though it has spread, this virus is really still having the greatest impact in China. It's the world's second largest economy. The most obvious issue is the loss of immediate revenue. Now, international airlines have had to cancel flights to China. Chinese shopping malls are empty, meaning companies like Nike and lots of others aren't seeing the sales they typically would. And many of the countries around China, including the U.S. here, rely on Chinese tourists to come and spend their money. And now that travel has all but stopped to and from China, we'll see hotels, restaurants, and other retailers have lower revenue numbers. But perhaps even a bigger issue than the immediate revenue losses will be the longer-term fallout to the global supply chain. This is often referred to by economists as a supply shock, which is simply a major disruption in the supply of a product. One report I saw said that for every day the Chinese factories weren't running, the finished product in the U.S. would see a 5-day delay, and already some U.S. companies are saying there will be at least a 4 to 6 week interruption in their supply of goods. Now, this doesn't always have to be the actual product that consumers end up buying, but it could be a component that's required to finish that product. And now that manufacturing has ground to a halt in China and is slowly getting restarted, the supply chain is probably going to experience some disruption. For example, take Apple. Apple relies heavily on manufacturing plants in China to send in the components needed to make their iPhones, computers, and iPads, and all the other stuff they make. And they've already warned that revenue will be down and a possible iPhone shortage could follow. And then companies like Samsung, Microsoft, some of the auto manufacturers, and a host of other companies have started to sound the same alarms. So how could this affect Social Security benefits? Well, there's both the longer-term effects and the shorter-term effects. The long-term impact is mainly in how long the Social Security Trust Fund will last. Right now, it's expected to be empty in 2035, which will result in a benefits cut. But this projection of lasting until 2035 hangs on a few economic projections that could go either way. For example, the Social Security trustees forecast the unemployment rate at a certain percentage. If more people work than they forecast, there will be more paid in through employment taxes, thus extending the life of the trust fund. But the inverse is also true. If there are more people unemployed than anticipated, there will be less people paying in, thus shortening the life of the trust fund. The unemployment rate is the most obvious of the economic factors affecting the long-term health of the trust fund. But there are also a few other things like wage growth, GDP, and inflation that play a part. These are all economic factors that could decrease the lifespan of the trust fund, but that's the long-term impact. In the short term, we have the annual cost of living adjustment. The way this is calculated is by measuring the changes in inflation. The Bureau of Labor Statistics keeps up with this number and calls it the CPIW. This is meant to be a representation of all of the stuff that we pay for throughout the year. And for those who are curious, the major categories are food and beverages at 16%, housing at 39%, apparel at 3%, transportation at 19%, medical care at 8%, recreation at 5%, education and communication at 7%, and other at 3%. Within these broad categories, there are dozens of subcategories, and if you want to see them, there's going to be a link in the description from the Bureau of Labor Statistics that details it all out. So there's a few things going on here that could push this next cost of living adjustment either way, but I suspect the impact will likely be that it has any effect, it's going to make our benefits go higher. If you remember the Economics 101 rule about supply and demand, when demand exceeds supply, prices go up. And if prices go up, the measurement of inflation will as well, and your Social Security benefit will follow. Now, ultimately, there's not a lot we can do about what happens to your Social Security benefit. We'll just have to take that as it comes. But we can be proactive about your other retirement income. I'll share a few thoughts with you that I've shared with my other clients when I'm asked, Devin, what should we do? Should we change strategy? Should we move to cash? Should we do whatever? My answer is, and will continue to be, absolutely not. Not based on this news. There's rarely a need to disrupt a solid long-term investment strategy based on short-term headlines. If you go back and look at the other major viral outbreaks from 2001 to 2020, including SARS, the avian flu, the swine flu, MERS, Ebola, and Zika, this market has mostly shrugged these off, and in hindsight, you can't even really tell the market declined and had some volatility. Now, who knows exactly how this is going to play out, but I suspect that once again, history is going to repeat itself and things will get back to normal. Now, this doesn't mean that we're not going to continue seeing some market gyrations in the days ahead, especially if this spreads in a meaningful way to the U.S. If that happens, things are probably going to get nastier, but my opinion about what we should do, it's not going to change. Now, this is for individuals who already have a balanced portfolio that's properly diversified, and that means a lot more than just owning a lot of investments, and a solid plan in place. If that's not you, you probably do need to do something. So if you want someone to review your portfolio to make sure it's positioned correctly, don't hesitate to get in touch with my office. I'll put a link down in the comments where you can find me. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.